Tonight on TV One Life.
Hey, I'm Corbin. I'm here with my friends. Got some plastic, some slick shorts, and a sweet hill. And we're gonna do some slip and slide pond diving. Oh yeah.
Woo!
Stop! This is extremely safe stunt!
That's right, we got an enormous protective sphere, a giant blow dryer. We're gonna make this safe.
You're going nowhere fast.
There we go.
I get in.
All right.
Go, 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 go,
go, go, go,
go, go, go.
I'm an alien.
Corbin, go, push it, push it, push it.
Woo!
How was it?
It was a lot of fun. I kind of fell on my butt, rolled all the way down.
A little bit.
A little bit. I think I have a sore butt.
Yeah. Let's go.
It's so slick. Oh.
It was so slick. It was.
We're back in colonial times. This is how they ship women all the time.
Come on, come on, come on. Go, go, go.
She's going out.
Go faster.
All right. There you go. Move on up here.
Step up on the hill.
Turn around. Put your weight as far forward as you can. There you go. There you go, Paris. Thank you.
Welcome back.
I really thought I tapped into my inner turbo there, don't you think?
Yeah.
All I have to say is keep Josh away from those beams.
If you like food at your house, then don't invite Becky over. She'll eat it all.
My parents think that Nick is a mess.
Hey, I'm Sean Park here with the One Life Crew, and this week I've got one word for you. It's Tonka.
And the last time I played with tractors, I was about 8 years old. They were much smaller.
That was last week.
And they didn't even give us any instructions.
Let's check it out.
Oh yeah.
The student's assignment this week is to drive some huge earth movers.
What's up? We got these big bulldozers and a project to do. The one thing we're lacking is instructions. Let's give it a whirl.
Safety first. All right, let's get this puppy started up. Oh yeah.
I really thought Josh was gonna flip that excavator. I would not recommend popping a wheelie in one of those things.
I
keep feeling like I'm gonna tip over, so I don't really know what to do.
Where's the owner's manual on this thing? I got nothing.
I've shown up for lots of tests without studying, without reading the book. There's nothing more nerve-wracking than that. It's kind of like that with God. We should probably read the book.
If I got a little bit more instructions. I mean, who's in charge of this taco stand anyway?
I guess this is
I thought driving those tractors would be like driving a car, but there are way more buttons and controls to work with.
All right, guys, well, that was like a giant dust bowl. It wasn't very safe out there, personally.
I got one word for my move, wheelie!
All I know is I got out of the way because I thought you were going over.
So how did it feel driving these big machines without any prior knowledge of how to drive them?
I was not comfortable at all. I mean, there's a lot of things that can go wrong. You push the wrong button, you pull the wrong lever, and you're flipping over. So I was not comfortable at all.
See, that was my problem, is I didn't know what I was doing, but I was probably a little bit too careless, just sort of went into it, let's have some fun, I can't do anything wrong, and just about flipped it over.
So, how's that like our relationship with God?
I mean, I think there's times where maybe we can get a little too careless and think we have things under control or that we can handle them, and so when we go to do them, we leave God out of it, and
I think part of the problem might be that we go through just like our everyday lives. We're just going to work, just going to school or something. We're like, well, I don't need God for this. I've done this, you know, 100 times. I know what I'm doing. And we get to a big situation in our life and we really need God and we don't know how to deal with it.
Are you sad? Depressed? Slightly bored? Me neither. That's because we're watching TV One Life.
Hi, Andy.
Hi, Randy.
How are you?
Just dandy. And you?
Oh, I'm more refreshing than the Rio Grande. So, you want to go on a big adventure?
Yeah. What did you have in mind?
Let's go catch a gigantic bug.
That sounds exciting. But don't we need to get a body first?
Oh. I guess I got a little ahead of myself. Look at all of these choices. I don't know where to start. I think I'll take the blue one. Yeah, the one with the really cool fin on the back.
I like the one in the pink. How do I look?
Look at those legs. You look hot? Wait a second. You're a girl.
No, I'm not. No, I'm not.
Andy, we're going to look for an ant or a snail, not for some pants on sale.
You're right. I'll take the soldier instead. How do I look?
Better. Let's go.
That wasn't bad for a 20-story drop.
Our adventure has just begun. Stay low and walk in the shadows. Check out the sweet fin I have. I'm gonna swim so fast, I'll catch a ton of bugs.
Yeah, you probably won't be needing my help. You should be able to fin for yourself. Aw, look at the puppy. Come here, puppy. Come here, puppy, puppy, puppy. Come
here, puppy, puppy. It's huge.
It'll eat us alive. Run. Run, Andy, run. Run, Andy, run. Help. Oh, heel. Sit. Good dog. Lay down. Shay, roll over.
Don't touch me. I'm calling animal control and sending you to get your dog in first life.
Look at me. I'm a mess now.
Me too. This whole deal really just tears me up.
Does your life smell? Then spruce it up with internship. Internship is 1 year of travel, ministry, discipleship, world missions, challenges, motivation, transformation, adventure, and change. But wait, there's more. Internship is also TV, music, retreats, drama, events, prayer, friends, and incredible experiences that will launch you into your destiny. Don't you feel better now? Internship.
Bye, One Life.
Hey, I'm Sean Park, here with Jason from Hawk Nelson. And they're gonna rock it out tonight.
Oh, yay!
The crowd is screaming in the background right now.
That's a new insert. You know, just to make us feel a little good.
Cool. On this episode, we're talking about doing the things that God wants us to do. Mm-hmm. Have you ever bought something and not read the instructions?
That's pretty much everything I own.
Everything?
Yes. I'm a big fan of IKEA, one of my favorite stores. I have three chairs at my place that I'm afraid to sit in because I know if anyone sits in them, they're gonna break because I didn't follow the rules. And so if you ever come to my house and you're sitting at my dining room table, don't sit on the chair that's at the wall because it's probably gonna collapse. There, I just said it. Take notes, you know? Yeah.
Tell me about a time when you followed God's will and were successful. Has that ever happened?
I'm trying to think. I'm like, I hope so. As a kid growing up, I think every kid growing up, they all have dreams and they all have passions. And there's a verse in the Bible where it says that God will give you the desires of your heart. And just that thought alone makes me think about just music in general. I mean, it's something I really wanted to do, and I wasn't sure if I could do it. I was told over and over again that it would never happen. And I just kept following my dream, and I believe that's a dream that God gave me, and God gave Hawk Nelson as a band. And just by staying, remaining faithful to his word and to his ways, I think the hard work has paid off, and 6 years later, here we are. And I think that, I hope that answers your question. I mean, I'm pretty sure that does. And it's just one of those things. If you remain faithful in the small things, he'll remain faithful in the big things, you know? And
all right, grandmas and grandpas, boys and girls, pet gerbils and hamsters, get ready. It's time for the speed round. Put your hand on your buzzers. Blank should have never been invented.
Oh boy, electricity. Why did I say that? Oh!
Wow. Number two. Would you rather be stuck in an elevator with Barney the dinosaur or Big Bird?
Big Bird.
Cool. I find blank annoying.
Oh boy. Cats. I find cats annoying.
Let's go with ugly cats. Which do you prefer, a water balloon shooting belly button or a cappuccino dispensing nostril?
Oh, belly button for sure.
Why?
Because if someone doesn't know about it and they see me like drinking fluids from my nose, they'd be like, that guy is messed up. But if it's just like water balloon, it's like, hey, what's up? And your friends are like, hey, good to see you. Ah, gotcha. I'm more of a prankster than a coffee guy. Oh. There you have it. Perfect world.
Perfect. Final question. In five words, summarize this.
This is an awesome experience.
Okay, well, we got it already. I think you went over a couple, but that's all right.
This is an awesome experience. Five words.
I went by syllables.
Yeah.
He's sharp.
If you want syllables, this is amazing. This is amazing.
How did he do it? Fantastic. Well, this is Jason with Hawk Nelson. And if you want to find out more about them, go to tvonelife.com. Thanks a lot, man.
Hey, thank you. You're awesome.
If you guys enjoy watching this TV show, TV One Life, then you really want to bring one of these events to your city. We get into the presence of God, and we take everybody there with us.
You gotta be here!
It's really cool to see all those people come down front and answer the altar call. I just love going out there and sharing the love that Jesus has put on the inside of me with other people. Actually a lot easier than I expected to be. I guess that crash course from Josh really paid off.
Go figure. Becky not following directions. She was determined to make a staircase out of that dirt, no matter what I told her.
People say that I don't listen to directions or instructions, and you know, they're right. I really don't. I always think I'm right, and that gets me into trouble.
By the looks of the ground, we probably earned our paycheck.
Absolutely nothing.
So Nick's a little afraid of heights. Watch how quick he gets out of the bucket.
Hey, Joe! Give us a lift!
So would you take a look at that? Total disregard for Becky's instruction. Time for some donuts.
That's right.
What's new? But speaking of disregard for instructions, why do we find it so difficult to follow God's instructions?
Well, I think sometimes we have it set out in our own mind how we want to do certain things, and then what God tells us goes against what we had planned out. And for me, I can be stubborn, and when I have something planned,
really?
I want to
you?
Do it. Yes, yes, I can admit it. But when I have something planned, I want to do it that way. And so sometimes it's really hard for me to trust God.
I think one of the issues that I run into sometimes is God will give you this idea or something to do, and it's kind of scary because you don't think you know how to do it. And instead of sort of pressing in and finding out, well, God, how can I do this? What do I need to learn? You just sort of back up, and it's easier just to take a step away from it.
It's like my junior year in college, there was this internship that a church had, and when I found out about it and prayed about it, I really felt like God said, I want you to go do that. And so I signed up for it, and I'd never been to the church, didn't really know anything about it. I just knew that that's what God said. But as time got closer for that internship to actually start, I kind of got scared, you know? I was like, I have no idea what I'm getting into. And so I went to the first day of that internship with the intentions of quitting and just not doing it. And on the way there, God said, I've called you to do this. I want you to do this, and you need to do it. And so against my own thoughts, I just went ahead and did it. And to see where God's taken me since then is just amazing.
So if getting instructions help you drive the tractor better, how does God's word make our lives better?
Well, God definitely knows how we tick and how we operate. And when we walk with him and like live his word, it definitely makes our life smoother.
And you know, the Bible says that God knew us before we were created in our mother's womb, and he had ordained all the days of our life for us. So who better to go to and talk to about what's gonna happen in our life than God? You know, if we had a problem with, say, my Mac and the mouse button wouldn't work, I would want to go talk to Steve Jobs about it. You know, I wouldn't want to go talk to some random guy on the street.
Like Bill Gates.
Yeah. So it's the same thing with our life. If we want to know where we're going to head in life, we should talk to God about it.
Good morning, Tim. How are you doing today?
I'm late for a meeting with my biggest client. And to top it all off, it's at a restaurant all the way across town. I don't even know where it is.
Oh, can I help?
Sure.
Please input address now.
Okay, LaLonda, LaWanda, what's my estimated travel time?
40 minutes.
40 minutes? I've got to be there in 30.
Danger. Please slow down. The posted speed limit is 35 miles per hour. Please adhere to the posted speed limit.
Look, did you miss the part about me being late for a meeting? You just give the directions and I'll do the driving.
Continue straight for 200 yards and then turn left at Park Boulevard.
Park Boulevard? The traffic's horrible on that road. I'll take Atlantic instead.
You'll be headed southwest instead of northwest. Do not turn onto Atlantic.
Yeah, right. You're just a computer. I'm turning on Atlantic. Okay, I've got you figured out now. I'm gonna do pretty much everything the opposite of what you say.
Is the original destination address still valid?
Yes. Why would I suddenly decide to go someplace else?
Well, you're traveling in a counterproductive traffic pattern, and that just don't make sense to me.
Look, LaWanda, LaWanda, if I'd wanted commentary on my life, I would have stayed at home and listened to my wife. Get off my back.
If you would have followed my directions in the first place, then you would be at your meeting by now. And as a matter of fact, you probably should have listened to your wife.
Look, maybe you should just be quiet. I've been driving in this town for 10 years. I think I know a thing or two about where to go. And this is a shortcut.
This road does not exist. Please turn around and return to the highway as soon as possible.
Now see, that's what I'm talking about. You can't see this road, so to you it must not exist. Stupid computer.
Oh, no you didn't. Mr. Stupid, you the one that's stupid. Mr. Shortcut taking all day long to get to where you need to go, and we still ain't there. Now turn this car around.
No. Do you understand English? This is a shortcut.
Well, for your information, I speak not only English, but Spanish, Japanese, Ebonics, and 5 other languages.
This is OnStar. Will you be needing any assistance?
Picture yourself in a foreign country, changing lives. Come on!
My world
now. It's really amazing how God can pull stuff out of you that you never even knew was inside of you.
If I had to describe this trip in one phrase, it'd definitely be life-changing, because when I go home, it's not going to be the same anymore.
My world now!
Today we talked about getting God's help in our lives. You know, when we don't listen to Him or when we're stubborn, it makes things so much harder than they have to be.
Back in 1986, two ships collided in the Black Sea. Now, the worst thing about this tragedy was they didn't collide because of some bad storm or because of some fog. They simply collided because of stubbornness. They saw each other and they didn't want to move off their path. They wanted the other ship to get out of their way. When the ships collided, hundreds of people drowned that day. In our life, God simply wants us to surrender to Him, not because He wants to be a slave driver or to be a master that just tells us what to do, but really because He loves us and He wants us to be successful. Now, there's this guy, his name was Naaman in the Bible, and he had leprosy. And he couldn't be cleansed of this leprosy any other way than going to Elisha and asking this man of God what to do. And Elisha told him, go to the Jordan River, dunk yourself 7 times, and you'll be healed. Well, he went away disappointed because he didn't want to dunk himself in this dirty, nasty river. So Naaman's servant came to him and said, why are you being so stubborn? Why don't you do what the man of God says? So Naaman went to the Jordan River. He dunked himself 7 times. And guess what? He was healed. He was cleansed completely of this incurable disease. You see, God wants us to listen to Him, to submit to Him. I know you think that you know what's best for your life, but God truly knows what will make us happiest, what will make us the most successful, what will make us the most fulfilled in life. So simply surrender your will to Him, and then you will have everything that He created you to have. Today we've been talking about listening to God. And as you've been watching this program, maybe you've begun to listen to God and maybe you want to get born again. The Bible says that if you'll confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God has raised Him from the dead, you'll be saved. The Bible says that the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. Now it is a gift. The only thing that can keep you from receiving that gift is that pride that we talked about today. So simply humble yourself. Pray right now. Just simply go, Jesus, I want you to be the Lord of my life. Forgive me of my sins, and He'll do it right now. If you prayed that prayer, if you made that decision today, call the number on the bottom of your screen, or you can go to tvonelife.com and tell us that God has changed your life. Well, we survived this episode without any major injuries. So to find out more about us, go to tvonelife.com. You can read their blogs. You can go to our store. And if you'd like to support our ministry, go to tvonelife.com.
Over 1 billion served.